Randy Miller and Mark Alford.
Where are we starting?
Sure. From radio and TV. But do you know them as possibly the worst lounge act in Las Vegas?
Sensation.
Get ready.
Darkness stirs and wakes imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses. Helpless to resist, those notes I write. For I compose music of the night.
Yeah!
Randy Miller and Michael Seward on randymillerradio.com.
Some people say the blues is just a good man feeling bad. I don't know about you, that's not the kind of blues I have. I'm a bad man.
Bad man.
I'm feeling good.
But I'm feeling good. I'm feeling great, as a matter of fact.
I feel good.
You may know from that shout.
Hey!
It's TV's Mark Alford is with us. Mark, how are you?
I'm good. How are you? I'm going to shout the news.
Is that true?
Praise Jesus. Hallelujah.
Ozzy Osbourne.
No, you want to see my Ozzy? Ozzy?
Yes.
You know, he was coming in the Sprint Center.
I know.
Right? And he canceled.
Yeah.
So I went to see him at Sprint Center. Have you ever seen Ozzy?
Oh, yeah. I've seen Ozzy.
So he comes out like this.
Right. Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Sprint Center is proud to present the one and only Ozzy Osbourne. He comes out walking like Fred Munster.
Yeah.
Oh, you ready to effing party? And then he's shaking around. And he gets this big gun full of foam. And he starts spraying everybody.
Right,
like,
right.
And these kids paid $500 to be in the front row to get squirted with foam. I could have done it for 20.
We went to see Gordon Lightfoot because my wife loves Gordon Lightfoot.
What does he sing?
Sundown.
Sundown. You better get
bare.
Bare.
I got a lot growing down there.
Yeah, I got to wax my back. Do you wax anything?
I wax most things.
Really?
Yeah. Before you got here to the studio here at Soundwork Studio, Andy does part of that.
Andy, you're very talented.
When Andy Occident.
Yeah.
And when he's when he's not recording music and bands, likes to wax.
You kind of get used to the pain after a while.
You do.
Funny. How old are you now? You're like 68.
I just turned 60. I just turned 60 years
old. You're 60?
In October.
I could have sworn you were 70.
Thank you. I just turned 60 years old.
What's your birthday?
October 17th.
Oh, mine's the 4th. That's probably why we're dysfunctional.
That's one of the reasons.
Anyway.
Many of the reasons.
So when did you start getting waxed?
I guess I was 3 or 4.
Yeah.
I mean, you know,
came out area.
Well, you don't have to sign consent forms at that age.
True.
So
you
that
get
was good
the
for me.
Snippage. You get the
Mark Alford is our guest.
Hey.
So I understand.
Hey,
that
Mike, how are you doing? Good. Mike Seward.
Michael
here.
Seward just arrived, and
I saw him at the ballet.
You guys went to the ballet together.
I was in tights. He was in a tutu.
Did you do the ballet parking?
We did not.
Did you not?
Did you see Randy in the program?
I did see him there.
Yes.
Under a different name, Leo.
Leotard.
Leotardal protrusion is my ballet name.
Now, hold on.
And my Renaissance Festival
name.
Hello.
Yes.
Is that a turkey leg in your mouth? Are you just glad to see me?
Good morning, ladies.
What's the deal with those ladies in the bustiers?
Right.
Anyway, back to this leotard.
Morning, ladies.
Where was I?
Yes.
So I'm a happy, married, heterosexual
man.
By
the way?
Right.
I'm just prefacing that.
Right.
These guys' butts were unbelievable. Mike, did you think so? I had butt envy. These guys, these young 20-year-olds. I mean, and do they put socks in there?
How much did you study the butts of
the
people on the ballet?
Come on now.
Now, and my wife did have the little binoculars out. I didn't know why.
I was very impressed. I told a guy, we met him at a little reception afterwards, because I'm running with the Muckety Mucks up on the 7th floor. And I said, your butts look incredible.
and what do they say to that?
They said, thank you, Mr. Alford.
Thank you, Mr. Alford.
And I said, this is my wife, and she liked your butt too.
Yeah. Got a new place to park my bike.
Yes.
Anyway, I was where I'd set my bottle of beer on one of the guy's butts.
Did you?
Yeah. Just kept it there all night.
Very accomplished. Awesome. You must have had the VIP package.
I did. It's called the Butt Portal Package.
Right.
Hey, I will say, just a full kind of disclaimer. Yes. I watch.
Are we on?
I watch. Yes, I watch Fox 4 every single morning.
I'm sorry,
I think you guys do a very awkward job. You're fantastic.
Yeah,
and I just love all of the things, and especially the Tell Me Something Good.
Tell me something good.
Woo! Now the way this works is you do the tell. You have the song, and then people send in little things that are good.
Yes, little bon mots of levity and positivity.
Now we have. Also gone to that here on this show.
Did you steal it from us?
Kind of.
Are you paying royalties?
Let's see. Yeah. I got one here. Okay. Nate Heron and Shawnee said,
Nate.
Today is the 14th anniversary of having my goiter removed. Party tonight.
Woo! Oh! Salt on the house with iodine. Woo, baby!
Exactly. So I guess...
We've got them popping up over here Facebook. Here's one from somebody named Roy Dean.
Okay.
My wife... Just baked a batch of bran muffins.
Huh. Oh, okay.
Gotta go.
I mean, I just love
I'd
love the feature, though. That's fantastic. Yeah. So
that's all you got for me?
Tell me Linda DePrima of Lakewood.
No, but wait, there's more.
Wants us to know that for Mardi Gras, she's dressing her dog Sammy up as a crawdad. Have you ever seen anything as cute as that, Michael? I mean, have you ever seen anything? Oh my gosh.
I love it. You got to eat those with hush puppies.
Did you have another one of those?
Yeah, well, they keep coming in.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, but go ahead.
I don't even know what this means. It just says, Loco the parrot is finally out of the rafters. I don't even know that means.
Ruby Roy McCaw got loose?
Oh, tell me about it.
If it's good, I will.
Roger Carson of Stillwell says, the toenail on my big toe finally grew back. Oh, now I can wear sandals.
So I heard he was in a jam for a while.
He was all kinds of stuff. What is the how many jobs do you have? So Mark Alford is the anchorman, obviously on Fox 4. Mm-hmm. He's a realtor. He will make you a suit.
Yes.
He will wax you. What other things? What other?
I'm the
talents?
Butt sculptor at the Kansas City Ballet.
He's got your back.
That's right.
Hey,
you got to have some side hustles. Right.
You know what? I call it insurance because in this business, as you know, Randy, you could get fired at any time.
Not me.
No, you've never been.
Not me.
But as an independent contractor, don't you feel more secure in who you are?
Yeah. Listen, I've suspended myself 4 times from this show.
You weren't even dressed in prison garb.
We got another one. Jerry Newberry of Kansas City checks in with his brand new medical marijuana prescription, and he said, I am completely baked. Thank you, Jerry.
That smoked me something good. What do you think?
Do you have another?
Another one. I just came in from Graham from Olathe.
Yeah.
I just got a random... I'm sick and won't be in email from Nick Vassos.
Oh!
Yeah, boy, that's the big breaking story.
He calls in sick a lot. Yeah, you notice that?
Well, just for the attention. I think he does it just for the attention.
I don't know. I think he's pissed at me, so he doesn't want to be around me. I'm not being around that offer, guy. I'm calling in sick.
This is what I love about Mark on the show. I don't care which reporter is wherever they are, it's... Mark has to have a question at the end. And I know it just makes them crazy.
It does. But I ask good questions.
Well.
No?
So Mark will say, and he always starts the question with this, I am best friends with Mayor Quentin Lucas.
But.
He starts with that.
Right.
And then he goes on and asks him.
I never said I'm best friends.
Yes, you did.
I said we're friends.
I have his cell phone number.
I do. We text. In fact, you want to call him?
No. Yeah, let's go.
The reason I ask questions is because I'm trying to dig deeper.
You're trying to dig deep.
To go beyond the news release.
You want...
We have wonderful reporters, but I want... Yeah. You know what I want to do is tell me something good.
Yeah.
And I've started doing this. Tell me something new.
Oh, wow.
So now I'm pitching the reporters. Hey, Kathy, tell me something new.
Tell me something... Wow. And is there a... Maybe we could do that song, Andy.
Tell me something new.
I feel like...
our reporters are great, and they do, but, you know, in the mornings, we got to keep on track. None of these press releases, tell me something new, something I don't know.
But speaking of keeping on track, I feel like, Mark, you don't even... even look at the teleprompter in the morning. So
I'm wondering how
everybody else is scrambling.
Why look at the teleprompter? Because it's not going to be on time anyway.
That's right? True. It's always 2 seconds behind.
And exactly. It's not new anymore, is it?
Scroll up.
By the time you read it, it's late.
Oh, you want to talk about new? Hang on. So why is everybody that used to be in media or currently in media running for office? Mike Thompson,
right.
The former weather guy.
He's running for, he is a state senator. He's a state senator.
Dale Carter, the
He's running for
guy,
mayor of Blue Springs. Mayor,
and I just saw my first Dale Carter billboard mm-hmm. today, and it's the worst slogan I've ever heard for a campaign.
What's that?
The future starts now. No, it doesn't. This is the present. Guess what? The future starts in a little while.
The future
starts. How can I vote for a guy that doesn't even know what time is?
Maybe he's going back to the future.
Like, well, he called me, so you're going to vote. And I said, I'll vote for you in the future. But I mean, I don't understand what the slogan is.
And Carly Ritter's weather aware. What kind of slogan is that? We're weather aware.
2020.
Listen, I got to tell you though, if you're married to a woman with horses, you got to be weather aware.
Okay.
I mean, that's the only, my wife.
Carly has, your wife has horses.
Oh, yeah. I mean, she, she can tell
because
you the weather.
Because they could colic?
I mean, I guess they could.
Honey, the temperature's dropping. Get out there and tend to the horses. I mean, they're going to colic.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's get another one in. Right. This is great. Let's see. Andy Oxman from Blue Springs.
Andy, I know Andy. Yeah.
Sent in a picture of him wearing his newest purchase, an apron with the phrase, Mama Knows Best.
Aww.
Thank you, Andy. You have one?
I do. I'm not sure if there's a typo on this one or not. Hmm. It just says, hey, we used Rob Hamill plumbing, mm-hmm. and we're back up and running under $20,000.
Wait a minute. I got one.
Darryl, no cracks.
Darryl Lewis from Liberty says, mm-hmm. today is the day I get drunk.
Woo!
Thank you, Darryl.
Darryl.
Thank you, Darryl.
You know, you need to watch the morning show. Have a little sauce and watch the morning show. It'll start making sense to you then.
You know, you do a podcast.
I do. Getting Comfortable. You were on that.
I was on that.
That's the first time you've really done a spit
3 minutes.
Take.
Yes.
Remember that?
Yes.
That was an actual spit take.
That was good. I think you should call your podcast Pocket Square.
Why?
Because you.
Oh, because that's my signature.
Yeah.
I'm not wearing one today.
Yeah.
You know why I do that?
Pocket Square.
P.S.
A man's got to have a. Why am I playing with my.
I don't know.
Man.
It goes back to the ballet.
Tell me something good from Mark Alford.
A man's got to have
my
a
nipples
little,
today.
A man's got to have a little silk on him.
That is true. You know who.
And I don't wear a tie.
Yes.
So I wear a little silk to
and
give
do you
a little
know,
pop.
Do you know who really appreciates that?
Who?
Greg Crowley.
Greg Crowley from
yes.
Crowley Furniture?
Yeah. Greg Crowley will say
At
to me,
Crowley!
When I'm directing his commercials, yeah. I will say, let's go casual. And he goes, Mark Alford always wears a pocket square.
See? He got some new suits, too. How come I'm not making his suits?
From Antonio.
Oh, I know Antonio. How come he doesn't buy them from me?
That's what I told him.
I love his latest pocket square. It's like made of flex steel, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on, wait a minute, Michael. Yeah. This guy has put my kids through college, which I thank you, Mr. Crowley.
That's right. Mine too.
And your daughter with the lovely shoulders.
Yes.
I can't remember her name.
Laura.
What's her name? Laura. She's
lovely
awesome.
Shoulders.
Fantastic.
She does. She's Michelle Obama shoulders.
Oh, she's incredible.
Right? She works out.
She got guns.
Yeah. And Greg, I think, is a good golfer. He's never invited me.
Not really.
Anyway, but he's not. He's scratch, right? He scratches a lot. Anyway,
that's pool.
On the break.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. This just in.
This just, okay. Oh, wow. That is one big clown. Corona the clown says, watch out for Mr. Wiggly.
Mr.
I don't, you know.
Is he a Shriner?
They just keep coming in.
Yeah, this is weird. My neighbor forgot to pull down the blinds. I don't know what that is.
I don't know. Wow. Okay.
Lord have mercy.
Woo. Anyway.
Anyway, Greg Crowley, I need to make you a suit.
Can we talk about Russian radio? I want to get your take on this, Mark Alford.
I don't understand that. What?
Please explain. Okay, this is totally un-American.
Okay.
And it's happening in a place called Liberty, Missouri.
Our Liberty, Missouri?
Yes.
With the great town square?
Yep. There's a little radio station out there called KCXL, owned by two people who are certifiable nuts. I mean, they are
crazier than you?
Let me tell you what happened. So Pete and his wife, Johnny, invite me a couple of years ago to this station. They say, hey, can we interview you?
Sure. This is a real radio station.
This is a real, yeah, it's an AM radio station.
They got a license?
Mm. So I get up all there, right. And they're interviewing me, or Pete's interviewing me. And he says, and it's going well, and he's, you know, he's telling me about mm-hmm. your career and all this kind of stuff. And so then he says, hey, my wife's on the phone. Can she join the conversation? Sure.
Sure. That happens all the time.
So Johnny comes on. And she proceeds to totally attack me. I mean, this is a live interview. And she's saying, how can you do the things that you did on the radio?
Like from 20 years ago?
Yes. So then and I'm just like, what? So we end the interview, he says, Johnny wants to talk to you. So Johnny. She goes, hey, weren't we great together? You know, what together? And she goes, oh, we make a great team. She goes, maybe we should do a reality show about this radio station.
And I what?
Said, I got to go get lunch.
Is this for real?
Yeah, that absolutely happened. So
instead of the future is now, the past is now.
So right. So fast forward now.
Okay.
And they're having all kind of money problems. They've got an AM station with 3 FM translators, so they got a decent signal now, right?
How many watts are they pumping out?
It's about 7.
Okay.
So, but
about like my iPhone chargers, 5 watts.
Right, yeah. So they find out that the Russians will pay $300,000 over 3 years if you let them have a chunk of time on your airwaves.
To do what?
Radio Sputnik. So Radio Sputnik is...
Is that like RT? On the web?
Well, kind of, yeah.
It's Russian propaganda?
Yes, it's totally...
Oh my goodness, and Liberty?
Totally Russian propaganda. And they're doing it just for the money. So, you know, they've gotten death threats. They've gotten all this kind of stuff.
What kind of show do they do?
I mean...
Where they eviscerate people and say, hey, aren't we good together?
Well, Johnny says that what they do is, and it's all about free speech, uh-huh. and what they do is they just talk about Russia and the many benefits. And you can go there and you can learn stuff about Russia. Mm. And actually... I want to.
Do we have a sample?
Let me see. I might have a sample. I'm gonna try and find it on the.
You're listening to Radio Sputnik with all the Russian news you need to know. Okay. The rest you do not need to know.
That doesn't sound very friendly.
In today's headlines,
yes,
you need to learn how to hate America.
No, that's not good.
That's hate America.
That's
liberty.
That's not in Kansas City.
That's not informative.
Next. Treat yes. every one of our neighbors with absolute contempt.
Yeah, that's not...
And finally,
yes.
enjoy some borscht.
Cool.
And hate everyone in America.
See, that's not good. She's got one too.
Oh, here's one from Ivan in Moscow.
Oh.
Apparently, someone has adopted a little kitty. His name is Death to America.
Yeah, see, I don't know if I can go along with all of that.
And that's in Liberty.
That's in Liberty.
I cannot believe that is going on.
It is.
The federal government has not shut them down.
No, they had to register as a foreign agent for that to happen.
Really?
Yes. It's terrible. It's horrible. I want to buy the station, and I want to ride in on my white horse
and
take it over and make it a show for veterans, a radio station.
Don't you do something for veterans now?
Yeah, the national defense.
Yeah.
So that could.
I think we ought to get Paul Manafort and Michael Flynn involved and take over.
That's a
you
great,
know
that's a great idea. Well, you know they're looking for something now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you know you could do it from behind bars.
Hey, what do you think?
Hey, we're going to change the subject. Not getting political here.
Well, no, we can get political.
No, I don't want to. I don't like politics.
Because I want to.
I get in trouble
about something else on your station that is deeply disturbing to me.
My reading of the teleprompter. What?
Why does Wendy Williams have a show?
Wendy Williams.
Huh?
She is so awesome.
Oh.
Is she on our channel?
I think so.
You sure? I think she's on another channel.
Oh, my gosh.
Somebody look that up. I don't know.
She,
What did she say about Phoenix?
Yeah.
What's his name?
Well,
Joaquin.
No, that was before. You
and
know what she said yesterday?
What?
About Drew Carey's ex-fiance that got thrown off a third-floor balcony?
No, what?
Come on down!
Like Price is Right?
Yeah.
She didn't.
Oh, look it up. I mean, that to me, why is she still? Now, come on. She should be fired for that.
I can't comment on programming if it's if it is indeed on our station.
It's the top story if you look her up.
Yeah.
Is she on our station?
Is she on?
I don't know. I barely watch our show. I don't know.
And that's while you're on it.
I really don't.
While you're on it.
I don't watch. I see we have this Mel Robbins. Have you seen her too?
I have not seen Mel Robbins.
You remember Sally Jesse Raphael?
Yeah.
Well, she died.
I was on Sally Jesse's show.
She died and came back as Mel Robbins.
is that about?
She's got these glasses.
Yeah, right.
But they're not red. You remember Sally Jesse was red? Sure. And I'm like, everyone knew Sally Jesse Raphael.
Yeah.
And this woman comes back. I've got this great idea. I'm going to have glasses in my brand. Honey, somebody's already done it. It's called Sally Jesse Raphael.
Sally Jesse. No, I was
she's
on.
She's got something called the 5 second rule. Have you heard that?
No. What is the 5 second rule?
Your wife said you know what that is.
I do not know what. Now is that when you drop stuff on the? No. What is the 5 second rule? I see.
FCC line two. Oh, you're not governed by the FCC, are you?
No, as a matter of fact,
that kind
of
changes the playing field.
I'm thinking.
Hello.
I'm thinking of doing a Russian radio show here. Yeah, I've got my host name will be Goshma Balsich, and Michael, you can be Ivan Rachakarkov.
What?
I mean, that's just Hi. That's for you.
You know, do you guys remember when Anchorman came out and you came on our show live and you? You were doing those Pride Cleaner commercials at the time.
Do we remember it?
Do you
Martin
remember?
I Zing.
Yeah, that's right. Martin I Zing.
It was funny. And do you remember we all dressed up great. Like...
Ron Burgundy.
Yeah. And I had on that coat.
Right.
I still have that coat from the 1970s. Right there you go. He's got the Ron Burgundy. Yeah. I still love that got the mustache. Show. My wife hates it.
Anchorman?
Yes. But she grew up in the, I mean, she wanted to be an anchor woman, and so she closely identifies with the character.
She was a reporter.
She was a reporter until we bought a horse stable.
and
the rest is history.
Exactly. You know, back to that show, though, I got to tell you, now I know you've got a new studio, and I'm just thinking it's
not
big.
You know, we spent $1 million on that?
That's a great looking studio.
And we don't have a USB port. How do you build a studio?
What?
They came to us, and they said, Mark, what do you need on this set? You're the premier anchor in Kansas City.
Yeah.
You're number one in our book.
You tell us.
What would you like?
Right.
And I said, well, here's what I like.
Yeah. Loco the McCall Parrot.
I like velvet seats.
I got to have a picture of Larry Moore
over here.
That's
right. Larry.
That's right.
Larry Moore. And my
tomatoes. Larry Moore.
Velvet seats.
I got to have velvet seats.
Right.
I got to have the temperature at 65.2.
Toe bath.
All right. Got to have a little toe bath because I don't like the junk getting caught up down in there. And I would really, because my phone, we do everything by phone and computers.
Yeah.
I would like maybe a USB port.
I mean, you would think.
You would think.
Yeah.
What?
I mean, the future starts now.
I mean.
Right?
You can go to the worst, anywhere in town and you find a USB port.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway. So what do you think we got?
An electrical outlet.
No, we didn't get that. Anyway, we're working on it. We're working on that USB port.
We're working for you.
Working for you.
For a USB port.
I know there were problems with us in the studio that day because our hair salons, our hair, for Anchorman hair, both of us didn't fit in the studio very well. But I'm a little surprised. I don't know if you are, Randy, that we haven't been invited back.
No, I'm not surprised.
Okay.
The security would not permit
that. I'm never surprised to be not welcome back. Anywhere.
That was so much fun, though. You queued up all these scenarios that were just awful to read.
Guess who I'm going to see tomorrow night?
I have no idea.
Jim Gaffigan.
Oh, I love Jim Gaffigan.
Yeah.
With the bacon.
Yes. He's in town at Silverstein.
Hot. The Ice Center?
Yeah.
I don't see myself going.
Hot Pockets.
Well, in hindsight.
He's funny.
No, he's great. Yeah.
A lot funnier than you.
Gaffigan. I'm not. I'm appearing here. Yeah, he's appearing at Silverstein Ice Center. Yeah,
What's the best comedy act you've ever seen in live in person?
I can tell you the worst.
Okay,
Daryl Igus. You remember a show called Fridays?
Uh-uh.
Yeah, you do. It used to be on Friday, and it was, and it was kind of a. And it was a kind of a spinoff of Saturday Night Live. Okay. They wanted to be. And so they had this sketch crew and all this kind of stuff. I was working in Pittsburgh as a hotshot jet pilot, and I was doing a morning
Top Gun.
Mm-hmm. And the guy came, Daryl Igus, comedian, came in, and he had just been made very angry by the last show he was on. So then we get him, and he sits down, and I said, "So, Daryl, how you doing?" He goes, "Not good." I go,
"What?
Okay, you're
on air?"
"Oh yeah. Oh sure. You're a comedian." And he and I said, "This is going well." I said, "Do you want to be here?" And he goes, "Not really." I said, "Okay."
Wow. Mm-hmm. But contractually, you had to be.
I said, "Well, then tell me why you're so mad." He goes, "Because these asses across the hall." I sit down, and the first thing they say is, "Make us laugh."
Oh, I hate them.
Oh, yeah. That's stupid anyway.
And it's I said, dance.
Yeah, right. And it, which is what I said, dance. And I started just shooting my gun at his feet.
They have a nice button in his tights.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Incredible.
Set people, a beer can on it.
He goes, "You know Mark Alford?" I said, "You mean Sir Gluteus Maximus?"
Well, you had another one that I thought was interesting too, didn't you? J.J. Walker from Dynamite. Speaking of, there was a story today you shared. Actually, the neighbor from We're Moving On Up.
Passed away. Right.
Yes. Yeah. She, what was her name?
It was,
it's like a French
name. She played the crazy neighbor.
Yeah, she was Mrs. Dothan. Mrs. Dothan.
Yeah. Good time, yeah.
And, but anyway, she wrote the Moving On Up.
Yeah.
Moving On Up.
She wrote that?
She wrote it and sang it.
Wow.
To a dear hunt department in the sky. Yeah, hey, moving on up. Moving on up. To the east side. I finally got a piece of the pie.
Here's the interesting thing about that. So, Jimmy, you've had Jimmy Walker on your show.
You've heard that story, haven't you?
Yeah. Well,
that's a classic.
We had something similar happen.
Really?
Yeah, Jimmy comes on, great guest. I said, "So give me a little dynamite."
Right.
And he goes,
"He's never heard that before."
500.
500? What is he, George Brett?
Right. I said, 500, what? I don't say, I said, "Can you do," so here's what we did. I said, "I got 250. Give me Dino." So he did Dino, and we put
I didn't hear this.
Oh, yeah, we put it together, and the entire liner then on the station
is
says,
Dino.
"Hey, this is Jimmy Walker, and you are listening to Randy Miller, and he is Dino-mite."
Did you have to pay him cash?
Oh, yeah, that was before Venmo.
So you heard what happened to us in 97.
Yeah, but...
way back!
Well, refresh.
Yeah, I haven't.
It was before I got there, like 6 months.
Oh, it was?
I was not there. So Jimmy Walker, he was with Craig Glazier, I think. You remember Craig?
Craig.
God rest his
soul. Craig Glazier.
Hey.
Hey, Randy. Randy, you want to come upstairs? You want to go upstairs? No, I don't think I'll go upstairs, Craig.
Did I tell you about I went to his house six months before he died, and I did a podcast with him?
No,
you
got
to listen to it on Getting Comfortable with Mark Alford.
I will listen to it on Pocket
Like the
Square.
Mayor, Craig Pocket was Square. A friend of mine. Anyway.
Craig, right here. Got his cell phone number.
He was banned from our station
for a while. He and Dare, Johnny always talks about you, Randy. I know he nasty her. I don't know.
Glazer brings Jimmy Walker to the studio. Now, this is second or third hand, because this is just what has been told to me. I was not a witness. So
bring in the attorneys.
They bring him in. Brad Harvey, who was the anchor at the time, was doing this interview. And he says, "How you doing, Jimmy?" "I'm doing not too good," kind of like your story.
Yeah, right.
He says, "What's wrong?" He says, "Well, this guy, white man, stopped me in the hallway. And was rude to, I don't know, he made up this big long story. Basically, one of the engineers didn't know who he was.
Right.
We didn't have security that at 5 in the morning, whatever it is.
Yeah.
And Jimmy decided he was going to walk around the transmitter office and all the electrical, you know, all the stuff that people don't normally go into.
Right.
And you don't know if somebody's back there trying to jack with your equipment.
Right.
And he just said, "Hey, can I help you find where you need to be going?" Is the story I heard from the engineer.
And older Jimmy Walker, to your defense, doesn't look like the younger Jimmy Walker at all.
Who is this guy? If you watched the show, you would know that's Jimmy Walker.
Have you ever had anybody jack with your equipment,
Mark? I have.
And I like it. But they stopped him and took him in the studio. Well, he makes up this whole story about how Fox was racist and all this stuff. And
yeah.
It gets out. And so poor Brad Harvey.
I remember that. Poor that, Brad. That's why you got fired and they brought you in.
You're exactly wrong. Yeah. But anyway. But Brad Harvey's like, oh, okay. But he didn't know that Jimmy was. And it, you know me, you know how I would have handled it. I said, Jimmy, you're full of BS.
Yeah, right.
But I probably wouldn't have said BS.
Yeah.
I'd say, prove it. Now, come on, let's go talk to the. I brought the engineer in.
Yeah.
I would have gotten right to it like Judge Judy.
You have another question. I have one more question for you.
I've got a question for you. Tell me something new, Jimmy.
Kathy, find out where those people are from originally.
Do you think I'm abusive to our reporters?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Do you like it?
I love it.
I call it tough love. It's love.
It is. Yeah. John Pepitone, what are you hiding?
John had a story today. John, I love John. He's really good. He's been around. He has the longest out queue in human history. John, you know, Pepitone. Our news director, our former news director, made him quit doing out queues because they were so long. Well, they'd take up half the newscast.
They were.
John Pepitone. Fox 4 News.
Yeah. Call
in Kansas City.
Now.
Almost as I love Jerry O'Neill. Jerry O'Neill is a great human. He's also put my kids through college.
Jerry put siding on me. Oh. Anyway, that's a different story.
Anyway. Call now.
That was the one that.
If you don't mind a few different colors of siding on the back of your house, we need to keep our men busy during the winter to keep them out of prison.
A lot of our guys, they're on work relief. They need something to do.
Relief and release.
And release.
I got Jerry's text cell phone here, too.
I'm not sure you do. Yeah.
He says, stop talking about me. I'm pulling my ads right now.
That's right. Oh, no.
Another one.
Seriously?
Horse coming in?
Oh, this is a cute one. It's a cute little baby and grandpa picture. Dave Wilson from Lone Jack says, meet our future lawn boy. I don't even know what that means, but that's a thank you, Dave.
Guess I don't think I should be laughing.
Did you have
one?
Another?
I had one from Roger from Bucyrus.
Okay, all right.
Mark Alford wore my favorite blazer today.
Ooh.
The Tony DiPardo Red Ruby.
Ooh. Yes.
Nice. Oh, very nice.
I made that for Tony. It's a crepe wool.
How about them Chiefs?
The who?
Is this not the greatest time to? Are you? Have you ever been this proud of Kansas City?
That's awesome, Mark.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What are you talking about?
Have you ever been this proud?
You mean like Roe Bartle, the chief?
Yeah. Ever. What happened to
he
Warren?
Was a good mayor. You know he's got a camp named after him.
Bartle. Hall.
And he's got Bartle Hall. Have you ever been to Bartle Hall?
Oh, yeah.
It's sure, big, just like the mayor was.
Yeah, he was gigantic.
He was big. He was a good speaker, too.
Ooh, why don't you do a Tell Me Something Big.
Something big. No, I think the Chiefs were very good this year.
Yeah.
I think they performed with excellence, and
the best thing I loved was the home crowd in Miami.
Oh,
man,
that was
did
big.
They bring?
I love the Arrowhead chop, or tomahawk chop.
Yeah, oh, that was fantastic.
I got to tell you, I might need a little intervention. This last weekend, me and the buddies I watched the season with, at 1:30, we started with the Houston game.
Right.
Oh,
we
did
went
you really?
On in full. To the Titans game in full.
Yeah.
And we wrapped up at 10:30 that night last Sunday watching the Super Bowl rather again.
Yeah. Yeah.
Have you watched XFL?
And he lost money on a Super Bowl replay.
You did?
Yes.
My
wife and I went to the Houston game and she doesn't really she loves the
she
Chiefs.
Doesn't get football.
She loves the Chiefs for the last 2 years and she loves Mahomes. But so we go to the Houston game, but she doesn't know all the etiquette in the stands, right? So people are, you know, we score a touchdown. Everybody's high-fiving, the whole thing. Somebody,
Kansas City first.
Oh, yeah. And somebody taps on my wife's shoulder and says, hey, high five. And she high fives him. And the guy goes, I guess you don't go to many games, right?
I mean, she didn't know what to do.
She didn't know what to do. I mean, they're hugging.
Do you ever go to games at Arrowhead?
Oh, yeah.
Do you?
Listen,
I can't stand it. Do you go?
I got a great story.
If I can get on the suite level, I go.
I used to have season tickets. I don't have season tickets.
I used to have season tickets, too. I got tired of people throwing up on me. Yeah.
I got a great story for you,
what?
Though. Benjamin Ranch.
Yes.
Right?
Dana Benjamin?
Yes.
Howard Benjamin.
Howard? Yes. Horse people.
Their daughter came to me at one point. We were doing something. She goes, my mom and dad are getting ready to give up their tickets. Would you like them?
Oh, man, I bet they were. Well, War Paint used to be stable there with Bob Johnson.
Yeah, right.
At Benjamin Ranch.
Front row.
Where Cerner is now.
50-yard line.
Get out of here.
For three seasons. Oh, my gosh.
How much of those cost you?
Like face value.
$80 back then?
Something like that. $60, $80.
My parents were neighbors with him. I don't remember him knocking on the door. Howard Benjamin.
Didn't get that. Is that right?
Yeah. Really? In Chartwell, 95th and State Line.
We boarded our horse there when we first moved to town. At Benjamin Stadium.
Yeah. I went to a couple of parties there. They started before they closed down and Cerner bought all that property, you know. It used to be Bannister Mall around there. They used to have Mexican rodeos. You ever been to a Mexican rodeo?
I've been to a bullfight in Mexico.
No.
Oh, my goodness, sir. Very exciting.
No, I think, back to your question, Kevin Meaney, probably the funniest stand-up I've ever seen.
What do you mean back to my question?
Well, you asked who was the...
That was 10 minutes ago.
I know.
He gave you the worst.
Kevin Meaney.
Jeez, it's like my wife. I call it spider-webbing. What topic are we on? I don't know what I did 20 years ago.
Jump around.
Your mom. My mom said something. I don't know.
Jump around.
Does your wife do that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's like, I want to talk about this. It happened 20 years ago. Like... I don't. Who are you?
Or she goes, do you remember Zelda? And I go, huh?
Who's Zelda?
She was our neighbor in Shawnee. And I go, I remember.
It's like left field.
We had neighbors.
Yeah.
You know, you gotta.
Had you remembered Zelda, that would
be more of a problem.
Of course I do.
Right, exactly. It was a trap.
But my pet name for her was.
I interviewed Nick Walinda. Yesterday morning.
And the tightrope?
Yes.
Guy?
Yeah. He's going to be walking across
a volcano.
An active volcano in Nicaragua in March. And I told him, I said, I know you're confident. You're confident. If for some reason you get to the point, you're getting ready to get on there, I would volunteer to step in for you. I said, I haven't had the training. I said, but what I would do is I would be a fill-in Walinda. I would be a Philinda. And he said,
Philinda.
You know what? He said, I will keep that in mind. I think he will. So I'm going to be ready. I think it's March 4th or something.
You've been on a few tightropes.
I've been on a lot of tightropes.
And you've always fallen in.
On purpose a lot of times, yeah.
Will you be sporting your Leo thing?
Leo Tartle?
Mm-hmm.
Kevin Meaney is the...
oh, good.
Have you ever seen Kevin Meaney?
Let me Google it.
Come on, we're big pants people.
Hold on!
We're big pants people.
I got a phone. I got
to plug that into a USB over here, Randy.
We're big pants people.
Maybe USB.
Nighttime sharpens, hidens.
We did.
Oh.
You missed our... Mark and I did a little duet. On the piano.
You did. Did you dabble the ivory?
We dabbled the ivory.
Let's do that again. We played Music of the Night.
Music of the Night.
You know, I almost went into Broadway.
Did you?
The deli down there. Yeah, that's right. Can I get a Reuben on rye, please?
A Reuben on rye.
Hold the sauerkraut.
Do you like a Reuben?
Is this a trick question?
No. I'm
Do
always
you know Bill Grigsby.
I'm always looking for a Reuben with pastrami, but you can never find it. You get the corned beef. Mm. You ever notice that?
Wait a minute.
You ever notice that?
What's the difference? Pastrami has pepper on it, right?
No, pastrami and corned beef, there's a huge difference.
What's the difference?
They're different meats. Pastrami's fantastic.
Well, hold on, I'm lost. Now you're spider webbing. What was I
Googling? Kevin Meaney.
Kevin Meaney.
Yes.
Now talk about your meats.
We got the meats.
Sponsored by Boyles.
Has
beef.
That guy...
Oh,
Boyles is great, but what's that guy's act? Boyles He's in Mission Impossible. He wears a hat. He does a voice
Right, for Arby's.
He has made a killing off of that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'll tell you who's made it.
Arby's makes a great Reuben.
They really do.
For fast food, it's excellent.
Corned beef.
I can't go in there.
Corned beef.
I don't ask for the corned beef.
Mark can't go into... a regular restaurant, you know, because he gets...
Are you peeing over there? What was that?
Jeez, usually at the ballet, they have an intermission.
That's a healthy stream there you got going.
I pee freely.
You must not be 58 like me.
Why, hello, Dr. Proctor.
Depends.
How are you?
I don't even know what I'm looking at. Forget that.
So Kevin, me. But yeah, he's
anyway,
he's
I'm
fantastic.
Sure I would recognize. Is he like Rubens?
Do you remember Sinbad?
Yes.
Okay.
The sailor.
Yes. Sinbad, when I
the
was.
The comedian.
Yes. When I was.
He was. Craig Glazier takes credit.
Yeah,
for
I
him.
Know he does. I know he does.
You're discovering Craig Sinbad. Glazier. He was a bouncer.
And I, when I did radio in Charlotte, I had just gotten married, and my wife was absolutely petrified of any kind of public whatever. So we go to the Christmas party in the Charlotte radio station, and mm-hmm. Sinbad is the entertainer.
Yeah.
So, of course, I'm the morning guy, so he's going to bring me up, and then he brings my wife up on stage. She still talks. You talk about spider webbing. Remember when Sinbad took me on stage? Yes, honey.
And when you say took her on stage, you meant brought her up.
Just brought her up and, okay. and embarrassed her. And yes.
Remember when Sinbad took me on stage? It was the night of my life.
And then Sinbad something. One day you will meet Craig Glazier. He discovered me.
Did he grant her three wishes?
Well, I know she touched his lamp at some point. But that's a whole
different.
You're blushing. I think.
Does
I
your am. Wife like you talking about her on the air?
She likes me talking about her anytime.
Really?
Yeah.
She
in
needs
person,
that.
On the air.
She's the fantasy wife here.
She is the fantasy wife.
How long
wife.
You been married?
Call in.
Happily.
Or how long has she been married?
Right.
Happily.
It is coming up this
how
year.
How long have you been married?
37
seriously.
Years.
How about you, Michael? Wow. Are you married?
I am married.
Yeah. To a man.
That's okay.
That's okay. That's all right.
A beautiful wife. You met Kelly at the
I
ballet.
I met her. Was
you
that
did.
Your wife?
You did.
She I was, thought it was your girlfriend.
She was cracking up at us. So you and you might recall, you and I are chatting. Meanwhile, there's an elevator to go up to the
right.
coffin that is full. And she's like, do you have any self-awareness, Michael? You're holding the door open and just having this long conversation
right.
with Mark Alford.
Well,
she's like, get.
I tend to capture people's
hey,
16 years, though.
When you see Mark Alford out in public,
hey,
well,
E.F. Hutton. You got to stop.
E.F. Hutton who?
Exactly.
You got to stop and say, hey, no one reads a teleprompter.
I like that guy.
Well, I've seen Jeff Gaffigan. He's one of my favorites.
Okay, it's Jim Gaffigan.
It's Jim.
So maybe.
Oh, you haven't seen his brother?
Is his brother appearing there also?
We're here all weekend.
Actually, Jeff Gaffigan is appearing at the Silverstein actual
That's
office.
Why the tickets are so cheap. It's Jeff Gaffigan. It's not Jim. And he doesn't do bacon. He does pastrami.
Hey, I went to see Jill Cosby. She was great. She was fantastic. Oh,
so do you?
And that Barry Seinfeld when he comes in, he's crazy.
I was gonna say I wanted to see Sebastian Maniscalco. Have you guys
oh,
seen?
Yeah.
He's one of my favorites.
He's funny.
Or maybe his name like is Sebastian. I don't remember.
It sounds like a skin disorder. What is it?
Sebastian Maniscalco. If you
yeah,
got
I got a touch
Netflix,
right
check
right
your
here.
I think that was one of our tell me something good.
Going back to
what about give me the skinny on Carrie Stoll.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I'm not talking about.
Yes. We'd like to hear that.
She's a very sweet person and does a great
her
job.
Her mom used to call into my radio show.
I know. She told me.
Yeah, I know. And she was,
why are we reliving this?
I'm just telling you this because she flies in from Hollywood so often.
She does every
yeah,
morning.
Yeah. I mean, her.
She's our Hollywood reporter.
That's right.
Because we got big bucks, can't afford a USB port, but
right.
we fly this chick
well,
to Hollywood and back.
That's okay. That's fine.
But we know where our priorities are.
And Sean
paying
Edwards.
Mark Alford salary.
Huh? Sean Edwards, too. He's off.
John
Edwards. Jet setting.
But he's not, he doesn't go out to Hollywood
no.
like Carrie does.
No, we've had Sean
she
Edwards.
She goes out and gathers the info and comes back every yeah. morning.
Sean's a force, man. Sean's.
Sean is awesome.
He's doing well. Yeah, he's very good. And he's been on this show several times.
Every year but this year on the Oscars.
Well, we didn't
what
we
happened?
Didn't really invite him.
Maybe since the Hotel Phillips thing that he was a...
You know what? That could have been a fly in the
way. We got him right at Fox 4.
Have you done that?
What?
You should.
The Hotel Phillips thing? I did
you
that.
You should. With your... Speakeasy. P.S. Speakeasy at Hotel Phillips.
You go and talk.
It's
and,
an intimate thing down in the bunker.
Yeah, they got a speakeasy there at Hotel Phillips, and they have a regular series where they bring people in to talk.
Your buddy Tech
talk
Nine,
about like
Randy
TED
Miller.
Talks?
Tech Nine did.
It's
did.
It's a TED Talk?
Kind of.
Yeah. It's a Phillips talk.
It's a Phillips talk, yeah. So you go in there and you talk.
About what?
Kemper's been in there.
Your career.
It's a speaker series.
Why have I not been invited?
Exactly. That's what I'm asking. That's an oversight.
Do they have teleprompters there I could read?
You know what? Randy and I will go and hold up cue cards.
That'd be hilarious.
Could we do that?
That'd be hilarious.
Scroll up! You know, I used to get in trouble. Well, the thing is, I don't really follow the prompter. Because Dan Rather told me.
Right.
When I used to work in Dallas, I did an interview with him. And that, you remember he was, when he anchored with Connie Chung?
Oh, yeah.
He hated her guts.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah,
of course. Why is this? Oh, God.
Dude, Johnny Carson, I did not.
I did not know that. I never knew that.
Oh, listen. I interviewed
your spider webbing.
Gilbert Gottfried.
Yeah, he is.
Well, no. This ties in.
It's hard, Mark. Yes. It's really
I
hard.
Interviewed Gilbert.
He does the parrot on Aladdin.
He does the parrot.
Right.
And so I'm talking to him because he was on the newer last version of the Hollywood Squares. And I said, "Well, you're the Paul Lund.
You're such an animal.
And he had some horrible stories about
Paul Lynn?
Yeah.
Like he was a bad person?
Yes. Yeah.
I found that hard.
I said, I just can't believe it. He was Uncle Arthur on Bewitched. Come on,
Sammy.
I know,
Uncle Arthur.
Yeah. So I can't believe that.
What was I talking about before? My head is spinning.
What was he talking about?
Well, we were talking about getting you on Hotel Phillips speakeasy.
Huh?
Speakeasy.
Oh, the speakeasy.
The speakeasy, yes.
The teleprompter.
Yes.
Why I don't follow the teleprompter, and I yell out, scroll up!
Yeah, yeah.
It's because I am.
I thought I was doing something wrong watching you.
I know, I'm like adjusting my TV every morning.
I mean, I'm going.
He says that.
Mark goes, scroll up! And I go, what do I do? I'm trying to watch as closely as possible.
I do a hard reboot. I'd shut down and turn it back up.
I just had no idea. So it's not the viewer's fault.
No.
Okay.
Stop!
Put that can down!
Turn over!
Just wet myself.
Woo!
But why do you do that, Mark?
I don't know.
Alfred?
Because I'm old and washed up and I have nothing to live
Tell
for.
Tell us something good, Mark.
Tell us something.
The scripts are,
yes.
We have great producers who write awesome scripts. They're just not necessarily in my voice.
Right. Do they not know you? I mean, they've
21
been
years. Me.
They've been working with you for.
I encourage them to get to know me.
How long you been there? You've been there
22 years.
22. Wow. I was a year off.
Yeah, March 18th will be 22 years.
Wow. Well, you had a good run.
It was good. I'm, I'm the mayor of Knobtown, so I'm going to do that full time.
You know what? I almost fought. I told Andy today. I almost filed to be the mayor of Lone Jack.
Why didn't you?
Because my motives were insincere. I just wanted to be called Mayor Miller, and that's not enough of a reason to file.
No,
that's what my wife said. She said, "Randy, that's not enough of a reason." I said, "I think it is, and I think it can convince the voters of that."
Don't you get bodyguards like in Lone Jack?
In Lone Jack,
yeah.
No, you get a horse.
A horse.
Yeah, they give you a horse. You ride through town. But no, you have no power as a mayor of Lone Jack. There's a board of aldermen, and you get one vote, and that's it? That's it!
Well, what's the point?
Well, right!
Now that they've redirected the highway, what's left?
Right. I mean,
sold a house out in Lone Jack, by the way.
Did you?
Yes.
What?
Went for $575.
What street was it on?
Tech 9 did not buy it. I don't know, but I had to be present for every showing. Okay, so the seller was very conscientious, and I was very conscientious as her agent.
Have you ever seen Tech Nine's manager's house out there?
Yes, I know Travis. Yeah,
yeah. Okay.
But I didn't. I wasn't his realtor. I would have loved to have been his realtor.
I know you,
Travis.
Yeah.
In case you're listening.
Yes, exactly.
But he has not chosen me to be.
Where
his
was
realtor.
The house in Lone Jack that you sold?
You go down off the main highway. You go down about a mile and a half south, and you turn right.
Oh.
And I don't know. And then you go around this little curve, like where the corn crop ends.
And exactly
there's a
if
double
our
light.
Listeners would like to take a restroom break, this would be a good time to go.
Go down And then there's a big oak tree.
Right.
And I think lightning hit it because it split in two, and there's some raccoons living in it. And then you turn left, and there's a metal gate there.
Is that by that ceramic donkey with the pot thing on the back?
Exactly.
Did you come in and not even?
It's a croc.
I mean, it's a croc.
A cockerel is near there. Have you been to Cockerel? Oh.
Have I been to Cockrell?
See, you should run for mayor of Cockrell. I got a lot of crocs there. It's all.
Have you ever been to Cockrell Market, Michael?
That's not. Nice. I don't know Cockrell Market.
Andy, have you?
Maybe I've heard of that.
Are you not into Franciscan wear? They have every kind of Franciscan wear you could ever imagine.
I bought the most expensive spatula there.
Is this that little bunch of shops I've heard of? You can't see from the highway. They're behind a bunch of, I've heard of it.
It's a village.
It's
a village.
We brought a dog bowl there.
Hello?
My dog won't drink out of anything else.
Anything. Honestly, I bought a spatula there that cost me. I put a down payment on it. I mean, it was like
leased with an option to buy.
Right.
But it's the best spatula ever.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Cockrell.
Mark, as mayor, I saw you coming in with a big frame. Is that, you didn't happen to do a proclamation for our show, did you?
I did.
Is that what that was? Would you like to read that now?
I got a copy of my phone.
I didn't know that Mark Alford was going to be here.
Whereas.
Randy.
Oh, excuse
a lot of whereas and wherefore. So you ready?
Yes.
Whereas Randy Miller has gifted the airwaves of Kansas City for more than 50 years, whereas Michael Seward has hung onto his coattails for a couple, whereas Andy has outproduced any producer in the Kansas City market.
That's true.
Yes.
Even though they're not officially on any airwaves.
None.
Fact check.
And whereas Randy Miller has been fired from more radio stations than any other radio personality in the Kansas City history.
Absolutely.
And whereas they continue to bring enjoyment and enlightenment to the hearts and souls of men and women in the Kansas City market. Be it so proclaimed. Randy Miller and Michael Seward Day in Knobtown.
Wow.
Intersection of America.
Wow. Wow.
Dated.
So dated, so filed, you need to pick it up at the strip club, all right?
So let it be written.
So passed.
So let it be done.
Thank you,
Is
Mark.
Is that your President Obama impression?
Was it? What was that to you?
So let it be written. So let it be done.
That's pretty good.
Thank you.
That's good.
You know, he's coming back. On the commercials for Michael Bloomberg.
For the folks.
Yeah. He's saying, hey,
for the folks.
Michael, I'm the president, and you're not yet. And I don't think you're going to be, but I'm in this commercial with you to give you some credibility.
These folks.
Yeah.
Hey, Daddy. Hey.
Now, you know who picked up on these folks was your best friend, Mayor Quentin Lucas.
He says folks?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know that.
He says it a lot.
I like him, don't you?
No,
like
I do.
Him?
I do.
Sly James.
So the recent,
Lucas, it's great.
The The recent thing that he did
is pardoned all the potheads.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
How do you feel about that?
I'm good.
Where are the Fritos?
You know. You know what a pothead's favorite body part is? Ear.
I don't get it.
Ear.
The ear?
Ear.
Oh, okay. You need to work on that.
Hold my breath for that long.
But these are strictly municipal convictions. They are
not. Oh,
I heard
your staunch warning this morning.
This is not for a state or federal conviction.
Mark was very
in a van
very
down by the river.
Very adamant today. That was another one of his, his tie. You know, they finished the report. Wait a minute. Federal. No good.
Well, and sometimes I feel like I need to clarify these things for our audience, because at the noon show especially, our audience consists of every resident of John Knox Village. So I know that folks listening at John Knox may have had a conviction in the past.
Hashtag blue-haired bombshell.
And that little, we call it the hash.
That's right.
It's the line between the birth date and the death date. And right. you're wanting that hash right. to that's work
right.
out.
That's right.
So if you got yeah. a hash conviction and it's in your hash.
It's not good.
Then Quentin Lucas is your friend.
Quentin Lucas is doing some great things.
Yes.
I think, you know.
He's what right. a time to jump in as mayor, though. You're down in Miami. I mean,
right.
Life's pretty good. Yeah.
Right.
He's getting a lot of national attention, too.
Yeah.
Hey, and here's my point. If Pete Buttigieg can yeah. run, I mean, look at him in the polls. What is he, 16, 19%?
That's not going to happen.
And that's of Indy, what is it, Indian?
He's an Indian?
No. What is he mayor of or was mayor of?
It's Elizabeth
Indiana.
Warren.
Indiana.
That's Elizabeth Warren.
I mean, that would be a state.
I know, right. It's a little state in Indiana.
No.
Right?
It's not Indianapolis, is it?
No, I don't think so.
No. It's anyway, a, it's a small, state. It's a small, 100,000
oh,
people.
Oh, it's Smallsburg.
Anyway. So why can't Quentin Lucas run for president?
Why can't he?
He could.
He could.
And you could be his media person. And
I can't even be Dale Carter's media person.
Has he asked you?
No.
You know, I'm a big Carson Ross fan, though.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
I love Carson.
Yeah. Who's Carson Ross?
He's the current mayor of Blue Springs.
Yes. Yeah, yes. I know. I know. Well, who's your buddy in Blue Springs?
But I like Dale, too, but I just...
Doctor? Know. The doctor?
No, that's Independence.
Whatever.
Dr. Don Potts, his
whatever.
Wife
that's Eileen
was
Weir.
Barbara Potts.
Whatever.
The first woman mayor of Independence, Barbara Potts. So, yeah. Dr. Don oh, yeah. Potts.
He's got a great record
sorry,
collection.
Sorry, this is getting yeah. boring.
we just lost our last two.
I know. The last two people just went good night.
Don't you like Eileen Weir, though, of Independence?
Oh, I love Eileen.
She's great.
She's fantastic.
She's well, good on Twitter, too.
Mark, thank you mm-hmm. for the time.
Are we done?
Tell me something good. I mean, what do we
have? Wait.
Tell me something good.
I think we do have another.
Somebody named Randy writes, pretty excited. What? I finally beat my buddy Michael at horseshoes.
Wow, that's pretty.
Tell I got another. Something good.
Jeremy of Blue Springs writes, "Hey everybody, look what's shining." I don't know. It's.
Did you guys? Hold on.
Tell me something good.
Stop the presses.
Right.
When did you know I was coming here?
When you walked in.
No, I committed one.
No, you did. You yesterday.
So you guys, and you have paper in front of you
thank
on these
you.
Little stands.
Thank you.
You have actually crafted these
yes.
jokes,
yes,
as we will call them.
We are professionals.
But you actually spent time and wrote this on a computer and printed out?
Yes. That's what we do. That's what.
And they're that lame? Come on, man.
That's why this show reaches tens of people. Mark, we look forward to seeing you on the news tomorrow.
Could you get Jeff Gaffigan on, please?
Jeff Gaffigan will be here next week.
Hey, I think he's on line two.
Bruce Seinfeld will be here.
Yes.
Jell-O bread, Jell-O pudding pops.
Anyway, I want to thank you guys.
Thank you, Mark.
For,
thank you for, yes.
Thank you for being a friend. No. You know, I'm going to be serious here before we go. I've been here 22 years.
Yes.
I love you guys.
I love you guys. I love
no,
you guys.
No, I really. You guys are part of the weave of the fabric of Kansas
it
City.
It is. And the only reason, honestly, we still do this show is for free concert tickets.
Well, there you go.
So, thank you.
To Jeff Gaffigan.
Yeah, Jeff Gaffigan.
Mark hey, be Alford. Sure and watch in the morning, will you?
Mark Alford, ladies and gentlemen. Fox
getting
4.
Comfortable. Getting comfortable.
Yeah.
With Mark Alford.
That you like.